I'm giving up on dieting. It was a super hard choice to make, but I am completely fed up with it. Hey y'all, I'm Wendy of Winning with Wendy.
Hey guys.
And you're Melina.
Hey.
Of Melodrama with Melina.
And we were going on a nature walk.
We're going on a nature walk.
And after that, we're going to the park.
If you're new to my channel, welcome. And if you are returning, I love you. You're awesome. I swear, I think people wait until I walk by to start their lawnmowers.
Wait a second. I found this.
Ooh, a big stick.
I'm gonna put that in my car bucket.
Like I said, I'm done with dieting. And before you freak out, sit back and listen. There's more to this story than you think. I've lost about 75 pounds. I say about because at my heaviest, I really don't know how much I weighed because I refused to get on a scale. We were trying to have another child and I was having trouble retaining a pregnancy. This is about when Melina was about 2 years old. And in the process, I was diagnosed with diabetes, hypertension, hypothyroidism, high cholesterol, high triglycerides. I was a big girl. As it turns out, each one of those things is a direct factor in your ability to be a hospitable host for a fetus. I'd actually developed a lot of these things while I was pregnant with Melina, but about a month after I gave birth to her, they went away. And so I didn't think I had to worry about them anymore. Wrong.
I love going nature walks because my mom said we might find some cool stuff. I found a little pine cone.
Fast forward to about 3 years after I thought I was all better. I was sitting in the GYN's office being told that I had a choice. I could have a daughter with a mother or I could have another child. That was the day I decided to do something drastic. So I'm not going to get into the details of what I did to lose weight because it was the most unhealthy way physically possible. So unhealthy that I actually lost about half of my hair and killed my metabolism in the process. But in better news, I actually lost all of my major health issues by losing all that weight. So for about the last year and a half, I've been trying to lose less. Whoops, that was a stump. I've been trying to lose the last 25 pounds and I'm gonna break my neck looking at the camera. I'm walking over all of these branches. I pretty much stayed in the same place weight wise the whole time. So I guess I've learned how to maintain. Melina, I've lost a few pounds, but I'm nowhere near where I want to be. And in steps Elizabeth Benton and her Primal Potential podcast. As I previously mentioned, I discovered Elizabeth Benton through Dave Ramsey's Turning Points videos, which of course I will link below because she's awesome. Elizabeth Benton believes in changing your mindset, changing the way you think. What basically happened to her is she went through the Dave Ramsey plan and she was able to get completely out of debt and she was successful at it and she couldn't understand if she could be successful at getting out of debt, why she was having so much trouble losing weight. I mean, they're both about willpower, right? So guess what she did? She lost 140 pounds. Her philosophy isn't dieting. It's finding foods that you love that love you back. Eating things that you like that make you feel fantastic. Clean eating and making changes that will last for a lifetime. And only doing things that you can maintain forever. No more dieting mindset. It's all about long-term life-changing goals. Simple, right? So in addition to finding out which foods I love that love me back, I'm gonna be working on changing my mindset. I'm losing the dieting mentality. You know why? I've lost weight before. I can certainly do it again. But I wanna focus on eating healthy and eating better for me foods. Because that laughing cow light cheese that I eat for breakfast every morning, that's just all chemicals. Yeah, it has very few calories, but it probably isn't good for you. Step one, I'm going to Elizabeth Benton's Ascend conference in Nashville. I'm super excited to be going, and I can't wait to get there. After I go to the conference, I'll meditate for a little while on the things I learned there, and then I'm gonna join her fat loss fast track in probably the winter or the spring, whenever she has the next one. If you're interested in finding out more about Elizabeth Benton or Primal Potential, I'll link them down below. Go check out her website. She's amazing. I cannot say enough great things about her. Her free podcast has already changed my life just from listening to it. So if you like the idea of following the last part of my weight loss journey, click that like button and don't forget to subscribe. See ya!
See ya!